Did you know that the Green Revolution had effects and consequences spanning the entire globe, with an increase in agricultural trade of about 4.3% a year between the years of 1960 to 1980? The Green Revolution allowed for an increase in agricultural production in any country that employed it. Well, you might be wondering what this video is about, so let's not wait and start. Beginning with the outline, the topics we would be discussing in this video includes the era of Green Revolution, the issues faced by Pakistan of tubewells, the critical issues in Pakistan agriculture during that period, regional and income disparities, and lastly, how all these economic factors impacted Pakistan socially and politically. One of the most important events in Pakistan's agricultural history was Green Revolution, which occurred in mid-1960s. As you know, when Pakistan came into being, we had nothing at that time, and from the era of 1949 to 1958, the annual growth rate in our agriculture was very low. Our government policies were biased against agriculture, but towards the end of 1950s, the government realized that growth in agriculture was necessary for the survival of the country. The reasons for growth were high-yielding varieties of crops, installation of private tubewells, increased incentives and subsidies on agriculture. Basically, the growth took place in two phases, from 1960 to 1965. The reason was the increase in irrigation facilities, and from 1966 to 1969, the reason of growth were high-yielding variety seeds, chemical fertilizers, and pesticides. Moreover, the complete package, which included water, pesticides, seeds, and fertilizers, were the major reason of growth in the agriculture sector. Moving on to some statistics, the output of major crops from 1960 to 1970 increased substantially. Wheat production increased by 91%, rice by 141%, and fertilizer consumption by 150%. Also, the growth rate in 1960s was 5.1%, which was the second highest growth rate in Pakistan. This era helped us to feed and produce enough food for the population of Pakistan. The chance of famine were also reduced, and we exported our surplus wheat. Tubewells grew from a few hundreds in 1960 to 156,000 in 1975. It is true to say that an installation of tubewells on a landholding resulted in multiple cropping, a manifold increase in fertilizer consumption, and more than double increase in the value of crops, proving that tubewell investment was highly profitable. The Green Revolution time period brought a lot of benefits for Pakistan, but there are a number of issues around sinking of tubewells. Firstly, in 1968, 91% of the tubewells were sunk in Punjab only. They were located in rich, old settled districts and the canal colony districts of Punjab. Outside of Punjab, there was very little tubewell development. In NWFP and Balochistan, the hard, stony, mountainous terrain made drilling for tubewells prohibitively expensive. In Sindh, the groundwater was saline and it could not be used for irrigation, and thus very little tubewells were sunk. Secondly, tubewells were mainly installed by landowners with over 25 acres of land because tubewells were huge and costly. Even middle-class peasants could not afford the variable and fixed costs. Lastly, inducement to invest in tubewells was given to farmers through large public subsidies on fuel, installation costs, and maintenance. Agricultural Development Bank of Pakistan offered loans with a fairly liberal credit policy and made numerous loans to farmers so that they could set up private tubewells. Up next, we will discuss tractorization. There were around 2,000 tractors in Pakistan in 1959, which increased to 18,909 in 1968. At that time, overvalued exchange rate made tractors available in Pakistan at prices considerably below world market prices. Agricultural Development Bank of Pakistan was also lending cheap credit at that time. Hence, the agricultural sector started to boom. Not surprisingly, most tractors were owned by those with more than 100 acres of land. Almost 75% of privately owned tractors were on farms that had sunk tubewells. Farmers who owned both a tractor and a tubewell had the highest cropping intensity, while the lowest occurred on farms having no access to a tubewell or were using only bullock power.
Regional income disparities. If we discover a close correlation between large farms in specific regions and tractors and tubewells, the impact on regional and income inequality would be self-evident. Green Revolution implies the introduction of high-yielding varieties with extensive use of farm machinery to improve farm production. However, installation of tubewells and access to credit were inaccessible to poor farmers, and hence they did not share fruits of Green Revolution. This revolution causing increase in relative poverty has made researcher Hamza Lavi write that the revolution has tended to intensify large disparities in wealth of rural population in different regions, increasing the incomes of the rural elite at the cost of poor farmers. Moreover, inadequate availability of inputs like water supply has also caused serious inter-regional and inter-farm disparities. These include Faisalabad, Sahiwal, Multan, who grew at 8.9% per annum. Moving over to elite farming strategy and capitalist development. According to Akmal Hussain, technology played an important role in the growth of agriculture through an elite farming strategy by concentrating new inputs on their farms. Farmers with great financial power were capable of attaining this technology, which resulted in the development and entrenchment of capitalist farming in these regions. According to Shahid Javed Berki, the rapid agriculture growth was led by middle-class farmers who were created by the shift in political power under Ayub Khan, where he took away political power from the traditional big landlords and gave it to the middle-class farmers. However, according to Alawi, it was the large landlords and not the middle class who were at the front of this revolution. He feels that the new mechanized methods did not bring into existence a new class of capitalist farmers, but it was mainly the big landowners who made the biggest progress. Such revolution resulted in increased leasing in of lands, self-cultivation, and greater income. As demand and consumption expanded, markets began to emerge around small towns, leading to increase in disparities in income and wealth among different strata of the rural population in different regions.
Okay, now let's see us together what are the social effects that emerged after the Green Revolution in Pakistan. Firstly, we can say that there was a change in the attitude towards education that was seen. Farmers became more aware with its importance in comparison to the mindset they had during Ayub Khan's regime. Secondly, the size-efficiency relationship was completely reversed. Rich peasants and landlords had more control over public policy and all the uneven investments. The agriculture growth did accelerated through an elite farmer strategy as large landowners began to resume their rented out lands to operate their own farms. Moreover, there was an increased social inequality. It was adopted within an agrarian structure characterized by highly unequal distribution of land ownerships. However, not only this, but the impacts of Green Revolution restricted only to the provinces that are the backbone of agriculture and had more land, like Punjab and Sindh. Whereas provinces like Balochistan and NWFP were completely missed out. Moving onwards, there are also many political changes that are observed after the Green Revolution as well. As we discussed earlier, the lack of policies made by the government to facilitate the growth created a lot of inequalities. So taking this into consideration, Pakistan People's Party took advantage of the situation and targeted people who were suffering from the disparity of their rights. As a solution, majority of the rural population chose PPP in 1970s election, which became one of the reasons of PPP's victory, as they made promises to bring agrarian reforms. Political situation changed because of the democratic government took place of the previous dictators. However, there is no doubt in stating that in 1970s election was the only election where economical conditions influenced political outcomes so directly in Pakistan.